to the part of the programme that generates more debate than anything else during the year, and that's the Sunday game Team of the Year. Now, we had a pretty forthright meeting early on of our selectors, and let's see what they came up with. I should point out the team has been chosen by all of our Sunday game pundits, not just the lads here tonight. But they're the ones who will announce it and take the flak.
Face the executioner. Yes.
Well, OK, they're lined up with their guns. Let's start with goalkeeper and go through 1 to 15.
Yeah, the goalkeeper this year is Stephen Cluxton. And just a couple of things I should say. For the second time in his career, he's kicked the winner in an All-Ireland final. He's Dublin's highest, second highest scorer with 16 points behind Bernard Brogan in the 2013 Championship. And, of course, the main thing is the kickouts put him on a level that all the other goalkeepers have to aspire to. Fantastic, fantastic goalkeeper.
Brilliant, OK. Right cornerback, Eamon.
Right cornerback, we went for Colin Walsh, Monaghan's Colin Walsh. They had a fantastic Ulster campaign this year, did very, very well, and he was one of their standout players at cornerback.
OK, well done to him. Fullback.
Fullback, we went for a man who has been on the edge of square for Dublin, Rory O'Carroll. And I think, Des, you know, in terms of fullbacks, you've Dermot Deasy, Paddy Christie, Gerry Hargan of this world. He has been solid on the edge of the square for Dublin for the last few years. And, you know, he's been a great player and a great servant of Dublin, and he fully deserves to be recognised in this team.
Great, OK. And we go to left cornerback then.
We went for Mayo's Keith Higgins. And the truth, Des, is we consider him, I think, for every position, bar Stephen Cluxton's. But he's had a brilliant season. And from a Mayo perspective, we'd be so proud of him. The pity, I suppose, is we can't photocopy him and put him into those other 14 positions. But fantastic season.
OK, competitive half-back line. Who gets right half-back?
Right half-back, we went for Westport and Mayo's Lee Keegan. He was fantastic all the way throughout. He actually scored in all Mayo's Championship games today and contributed very, very well, both in attack and defence. So he's a worthy recipient of number 5.
Centre-back, Ciarán.
Number 6, Des, we went for Keane O'Sullivan, Dublin's Keane O'Sullivan, Mr. Versatile. Was very, very prominent in Dublin's midfield all year, but when required, he was able to drop back into the defensive division and very, very effective, playing both roles and fully deserved that position.
Right. That's the camera behind you. Keane, left half-back then?
The left half-back went for Mayo's Colin Boyle. Again, I would say unbelievable courage this guy has shown this season. Can score, can absolutely defend, but it just the courage he has shown in driving his team on from half-back position has been absolutely tremendous.
Okay. So to midfield, the first of our midfielders.
This was a tough one. This was a minefield, but we went for Mayo's big man. He put in the performance of the year. As far as I was concerned, it was Aidan O'Shea. He was fantastic throughout Mayo's campaign, and he again, as I said, he deserved that award.
And with
second
him, a fairly easy choice, the heartbeat of the Dublin team, Michael Darren McCauley, you know, epitomised everything that was great about Dublin, you know, driving forward at every opportunity. He was the man in the engine room at crucial stages, you know, that really drove Dublin on all year.
Brilliant, OK. For that, he can get off homework in college tomorrow. The half-forward line, again, not easy pick this, right half-forward.
No, but this is a particularly good choice, I think, from the selectors. Paul Flynn goes in at 10. Kieran tells me, and he keeps an eye on these stats, this is the third year in a row that Paul has made our Sunday game team. Yeah. And it's a credit to his consistency. Another really good All-Ireland final again today, and marvellous player.
OK, well done, Paul. Centre-forward, Eamon?
Well, the best footballer I've ever seen is Kerry's Colm Cooper. He was outstanding in the semi-final against Dublin, and he deserves his position at number 11. Okay. Just enough said about him.
All right. Number 12. Okay.
Number 12 generated a lot of debate, Des, and we went for Sean Kavanagh.
That's because numbers 8 and 9 generated a lot of debate.
Absolutely. Yeah. And, you know, Sean Kavanagh was very, very good for Tyrone. Man of the match in many of their games. He drove them on, kicked a lot of very, very good scores all year, and he was Tyrone's main man.
Did Joe Brawley vote for him?
We must check
that, actually.
the full forward line, Kevin.
Well, the full forward line, I'm delighted to say that Kerry have got another man in here in James O'Donoghue. His performance in the Munster final, but especially in the All-Ireland semi-final. Now, you know, he really took the game to the current champions, the new champions, and he was marvellous in that game. The skills he showed and the clinical finishing with the kit dog was really marvellous to behold. And I think he gets in there, we're all agreed, he's a great choice at 13.
OK. Number 14 then, Eamon.
Number 14 was Dublin's former Player of the Year. He came in for a lot of criticism at the start of the championship, but he really, really got better as the year went on. It's Bernard Brogan. He's fantastic again today. He had a great battle with Joe Cafferkey, but you know, he came out on top with 2-3, made the difference as far as I was concerned for Dublin. And again, you know, just a performance to behold. Fair play to him.
All right, then. And number 15.
The other corner, we went for Mayo's Killian O'Connor. I suppose 6.22 in this year's championship. A lot of people didn't expect him to last the pace today. He showed very, very well. He got on a lot of ball. He was probably one of the most prominent forwards and very, very good all year, Des.
All right, then. We'll let our guest panel reflect on it. But first of all, let's show you our Sunday game football team of the year for 2013, and we can recap on it. Stephen Cluxton in goal. As you see, Colin Walsh, Rory O'Carroll and Keith Higgins in the full back line, Lee Keegan, Kian O'Sullivan and Colin Boyle. And looking and doing the counting on it, there are six dubs in the team, five from Mayo, two from Kerry, one from Monaghan and one from Tyrone. So five counties represented, six dubs, five Mayo, two Kerry, one Monaghan and one Tyrone. Now, this is the bit I'm looking forward to most. We're going to invite our guests to react. So, Alan, Mark and Philip, you've had a chance to have a look at the team of the year. So, Mark, if I start with you, I mean, obviously, there's a lot more than 15 players in contention. Who are the unlucky ones for you?
Well, I was just looking, Des, and I'm not too happy with that full back line, though.
There's no Shay missing from it, is there?
Yeah, no. It's nice to have two Kerry fellas there. I think Cullum and James are well-deserving of the being on the team. I think it's a fair team. I think maybe, you know, James McCarthy, Cian Mackey and Ger Cafferkey have a may feel hard done by, you know, because I think they had great years, you know. Ger was marking Bernard Brogan today, as you said. They had a great battle, and I think that you know, Bernard is just so difficult to mark. You try and keep an eye on him for 70 minutes, and you know, he got the flick to the goal today. He's very elusive, and but I thought Ger did a good. He actually played well on him as well. So I think Ger Cafferkey would be the one man who I think maybe he might feel hard done by.
Okay, Philip, feel free to complain here now.
I think with my Ulster hat on, I think Conor McManus had a fantastic year for Monaghan. He was really led from the front, especially come the quarter final stage as well. He was so close. It's tough to leave anyone out of that full forward line, but, and again, people's definitely going to say I'm biased to Ulster teams, but Cian Mackey I thought was fantastic. The improvement that Calvin made this year, and he was one player that was going to leave the country and go travelling, but they got him to stay and play football, and to make room for him, personally I'd have played the two best midfielders in the country. I'd have picked both of them in midfield. That would have been Sean Calvin, and the person who I thought was the player of the year was Michael Dara McCauley. So two Ulster men I think could feel a little hard done by.
Okay. And we'll get reaction on this. Alan Quirk, what's your reflections?
Yeah, I suppose to keep the people in the goalkeepers union happy, I suppose you couldn't argue with Stephen. He's been brilliant all year, but I think, you know, Robert Henley had a fine year as well, considering he was thrown in at the deep end when they lost their first two choice, one and two in Mayo. Possibly Martin Dunne as well. He was leading scorer in the championship heading in today. I think Killian O'Connor just pipped him at the post. Yeah. I think he had a fairly good show as well, but it's a very hard thing to do to pick 15 out of a very even championship. So I think the lads did a good job.
That's I have to say you've done better than I thought out of this.
more timber than that.
I did. I thought they'd horse into you a bit more. Conor McManus was mentioned by Philip.
Yeah.
That was a big talk.
He had a fair few votes. It was very tight. I think he was beaten by one vote, perhaps. So, look, this is only the first stab at it, but it's an interesting stab at it. I mean, the big gongs will be handed out by the All-Star selectors shortly. But I would say one more, and it's a Mayo man.
Yeah.
But I thought Shamie O'Shea put in a very good season.
The biggest dilemma, Des, was around midfield. You know, obviously Aidan O'Shea, Michael Dan McCauley were very prominent. So was Sean Kavanagh. So was Seamus O'Shea.
I thought he was very good.
It was very difficult. You had the dynamic of Keith Higgins, obviously, who had played in the forwards as well. Yeah. So, and
if you put Sean Kavanagh in, do you see? If you put them where...
Philip's point, I mean, we've two midfielders here. You know, your midfielder, Sean Kavanagh, was one of the best two midfielders.
He was. He actually got two Man of the Match awards, even in two of his performances from us here during the year. So you couldn't leave him out, and you had to try and find a place for him. Now, for me, he took the place of Dermot Connolly, who I thought had a fantastic year, was Man of the Match last year, or Man of the Match in last week's semi-final.
And he was exceptional. Who else was unlucky in your deliberation?
One of the lads touching it there, Cian Mackey for me, he's Cavan's. He was in every game he played, he was outstanding. Yeah. And that's all we look for, and that's what I look for. You know, I know he's from possibly the weaker counties, and you'll have people saying, you know, they never get the rub of the green. I fought hard for him, and I suppose, you know, there was an argument there for him, but for me,
well,
he
none
fantastic.
Of this I fought hard for anybody.
I think there's two inside forwards also that were very prominent, and to make a full forward line is very difficult. It was Martin Dunne of Cavan and Kieran Hughes of Monaghan as well, both very prominent for their teams. And
Darren Hughes at midfield for Monaghan he put in an outstanding Ulster final. Yeah. Somebody said James McCarthy, I think it was you, Mark.
James
McCarthy was very close as well. He had a great championship in many respects, so he was very close too.
All right, he nudged in ahead of Tomás O'Shea. Obviously, you can tell them when you go home, Mark.
I had nothing to do with the selection.
when the fellas start denying they've anything to do with it, you know we're in trouble.